Hey, what's up, everybody? This is your boy Kenny, and this is Too Close to Home, Season 1, Episode 7, and the name of this episode is In My Sister's Shoes. Now, the episode opens up with Dr. Allen still trying to operate on Victor, and Brody immediately goes into panic because he's like, what the hell are you doing? And Dr. Allen is in one of his moods where he's like, I'm trying to get the walrus out. I'm trying to get this walrus out. His mouth is open, and I'm trying to pull him out. Come on, you son of a bitch. Damn, Dr. Allen, did you watch it? Oh, my God. Like, he is literally doing surgery on this guy, and, you know, there's no anesthesia being used or anything. So Brody's immediately panicking because he's thinking that, you know, Dad's out his right mind, and he's now operating on this guy, and he could possibly kill him. So, the paramedics show up along with Sheriff Mobley. They go and attend to him, and immediately Brody asks, is he okay? You know, did my father hurt him? And the paramedic said that, look, yeah, he did a messy job, but he actually, you know, he actually got all the air out of his lung because his lung collapsed. So, your father actually saved Victor's life. So, they were actually shocked, like, wow, really? And Dr. Allen is still out of his mind, but they tell him that, you know, so what they did is that they stitched him up, but told him that they had to leave him there because they got another call with some guy who cut his leg off with a chainsaw, so they had to go by order of importance, so they had to leave him there. And then Brody's like, this is bullshit. Like, why can't you take him? He's like, look, he's in the hands of a doctor. He'll be fine. You know, we might send somebody over later, but we gotta go. So they end up leaving Victor there, and they did stitch Victor up. So, and it's also good that, you know, because of what Dr. Allen did, you know, Victor's life is saved for now. Next, we go to the trailer park, and Bonnie and Anna are sitting out, you know, drinking beers, and they're talking about life and talking about, you know, traveling and all of that. And, you know, we come to find out, literally, that Bonnie has never been outside of Happy. That's all Bonnie knows is Happy. Because Anna was asking the question, like, don't you want to go places? Don't you want to see new things? And she's like, for what? You know, besides, who's going to take care of Mama? Who's going to take care of the kids? You know, what, I mean, there's nothing out there for me. I mean, and, you know, what would I do if I were to go out there? You know, and next thing you know, Bonnie goes inside, comes back out with these shoes on. And she's like, check this out, Anna. You don't remember these? Oh, my God, girl, you don't remember? Oh, yeah, these used to be your shoes. So, anytime that I was missing you, I would put these shoes on and I would dance and I would fantasize and I would just get my life every time I put your shoes on. And damn, Anna don't even remember the damn shoes. So, that was pretty interesting because she's saying that, you know, well, you know, I know you had to go off and do your thing, but, you know, when I, you know, would miss you or when I thought about you, I would put on your shoes and I would walk around the house in them. You know, so that kept me close to you in her own way. And I'm like, wow, Bonnie, you have really been unhappy way too long. But next thing you know, Bonnie says she has to go over to Dr. Allen's because you remember she made a deal with Brody that in exchange for Mama's ring, she'll watch Dr. Allen every Sunday. So, but then before she leaves, she's asked, do you still have feelings for Brody, Anna? And Anna's like, oh no, that was so long ago. She's like, oh yeah, because, you know, he ain't the same skinny little boy that he was when you first fell in love with him. He's a grown man now. You know, a lot has changed. You sure you don't got no feelings for him at all? She's like, yeah, I'm fine, you know. Brody's gotta live his life. And I'm thinking, okay, Bonnie, you shady bitch. So, it's kind of proof right here you feeling Brody, and you want to make sure that Anna ain't still trying to claim him so you can get him for yourself. You ain't slick, bitch. You ain't slick. So, eventually Bonnie goes off. Next thing you know, we see Dex and Valerie has finally arrived and happy. So, yes, we got the gay and we got the blacks up and happy turning shit out. So, they immediately knock on Mama's trailer. Mama, being her big, loud, boisterous self, tells them, what do you want? What you doing here? Like, we're looking for Anna. Like, come around back. And they're like, what the fuck is around back? Because Hershel's right there. They ain't never been in no place like this before. And Valerie's still being herself, still being self-righteous as hell, talking about like, oh my God, this place is disgusting. Oh my God, this bitch lies so much. So they finally go inside, and Valerie's like, oh shit, I think I need to wait outside. Shit. I'm like, bitch, you wanted to come and now you did, so shut up. So they finally go in there and start talking to Mama. Mama's like, who the hell are you two? What do y'all want? It's like, well, we're from Washington, D.C., and we're looking for Annie. It's like, you mean Annie? It's like, we mean Annie. It's like, oh, no, you mean Annie, as in Annabelle. And she's like, so is it true? Is it true that she was sleeping with the president? And they kind of, like, dismiss it at first, and they was like, well, yeah, but we're really trying to look for her. We really need to find her. And she's like, well, what do you need to find her for? Well, she's like, and then, like, Des is like, well, the thing is, she came in town with my boyfriend. And she's like, boyfriend? So you mean to tell me you one of them Peter Piper looking for pickle peppers? Or, you know, pickle peckers? You one of them? And I'm like, you know what, bitch? You are doing too much. And she's like, well, I don't know what you're talking about. And, you know, I don't know what she is. And then, like, Valerie's still, like, questioning her, like, yo, like, look, we really need to find her. You know, it's important that we find her. You know, where is she? Do you know where she is? Do you know where she could be? And, you know, Dex is, like, saying, like, look, it's important that we find her. And then, like, Mama's like, I don't talk to your kind. But I don't know where she's at. You know, I don't know where she is. So, I don't know what to tell you. So, they kind of like, you know, and Dex was giving her the look of hell. Do you hear me? Dex was looking at her like, I'm going to fuck you up, you prejudiced fat bitch. Like, that's what's going on in Dex's head. So, when they about to leave, Mama's like, hey, you two never answer my question. And then Dex was like, well, I don't talk to your kind. I'm like, see? That's what happens when you mess with a queen. You want to dish it out, a queen can serve it back, and she'll serve it piping hot. So check yourself before you wreck yourself. And eventually, she's like, y'all get the hell out of my trailer. So they end up leaving, and then Valerie threw up in shame. She's like, that nasty white bitch! Ugh! And she's like, look, we gotta find Anna. So, Mama calls over to Anna. She lets Anna know, like, look, there's some people over here looking for you. And she's like, you know, really? She's like, she's looking out, she's like, yeah, they over here asking questions about you and about the president and everything. Like, you need to let me know what's going on. We're going to get to the bottom of this. So she hangs up the phone with her mother, goes out there and meets with them. Fucking Valerie self-righteous, and these are going in, you bitch, you're always ruining everything for everybody. And she's like, what the fuck are you talking about? She's like, well, we know that Victor's here, and we haven't been able to find him. And she's like, well, I've been waiting for him, too, because he was supposed to come by and see me before he left. And she actually mentioned this to Bonnie when her and Bonnie were on the porch drinking, that she was waiting for her friend to show up, but he never did. So, and then Dexter finally reveals that, well, I was talking to him last night, and he was at some type of bar or whatever, and it sounded like somebody started beating him up. And she's like, oh my God, no. I told him not to go to that bar. And she's like, well, do you know what a bar is? And she's like, yeah. She's like, well, hey, you driving, so get in the car. Take us there. I'm like, you know what, Valerie? If you was gonna be this fucking mean, you could have stayed your stuck up ass in Washington D.C. Why the hell you come down here and you still giving people the blues? I mean, I understand that I ain't a lot and all this shit, but bitch, you're being entirely too fucking extra. Besides, what fucking skeletons you got up in your closet, huh? Ain't nobody got time for your time for you and your bullshit. So they leave to go to the bar to meet up with them. So finally Bonnie arrives at Dr. Allen's house. She comes to find out that not only does she have to watch Dr. Allen, but she also has to watch Victor because, you know, pretty much Victor's bedridden. And she also tells him that Anna's back, and she's like, well, why? And he's like, well, why the hell are you telling me this? And she's like, well, I just think you should know. Anna's back in town. So he said he got to go work the field, so she's there with Dr. Allen and with Victor. After that, we actually see that Anna, Gets, and Valerie arrive at the Honky Tonk Bar. And they're talking to, I think the lady's name is like Daisy or something like that. Her and the male bartender, they go up in there and they are acting completely nonchalant and don't remember nothing. They're like, oh, we don't know what you're talking about. That guy has never been here. I know my regulars, and trust me, if that man would have been here, I would have known. So we don't know anything. And it got to the point where Valerie's like, and then all of a sudden, male bartender kind of looked at Dex like, well, it seems to me that this man over here is in his feelings. I wonder why. I'm like, you know what? Y'all motherfuckers are taking some undercut jabs, you know, because you know that Dex and Victor are gay. And they're kind of letting it be known that, yeah, we know something up with y'all. Mm-hmm. So it gets to the point where they go back and forth. And they're still denying that they've never seen Victor. So Victor pulls out his phone and says, like, well, according to the credit card, he made some purchases here last night. So we know he was here. So what's going on? Why are you lying to us? And then Miss Valerie goes in and is like, look here, you old dumb country bitch. Where the fuck is Victor? And they're like, Olga was like, yo, Anna, you need to get this ugly bitch up out of here because we don't take too kind to your type around here. And Valerie's like, I don't give a damn. Where the fuck Vic at? You know, because we can get the FBI, we can get the Department of Justice, we can get everybody up in here because obviously a hate crime has been committed here. And then Anna had to reassure her that, look, as much illegal shit that you two involved in, y'all don't want the FBI up in here, so y'all better start talking. So eventually, she starts talking. Oh, yeah, he was here. Mm-hmm. Yeah, he bought some drinks. But it was your sister's fault. And she's like, who, Bonnie? She's like, no, Shelby. Shelby started running up his tab, got him all drunk, and, you know, then next thing you know, he goes out and then something happens or whatever, but I don't know what went down. But if you really want to know more information, you need to go to the sheriff because the sheriff will tell you. So they pretty much had it with their asses, so they end up going to the sheriff. They actually talk to Sheriff Mobley, and Sheriff Mobley tells them that he's at Dr. Allen's house, that he was actually beat up pretty bad, but he's going to be okay, and that he's at Dr. Allen's house. So, and Anna remembers how to get to Dr. Allen, so they end up going to Dr. Allen's house from the sheriff department. Now, we see Bonnie is actually watching Dr. Allen. He's, like, watching a football game, and she goes in, to kind of, like, see what's going on with Victor. Victor finally comes to and starts talking to her and lets her know that his name is Victor and that he's from Washington, D.C. So immediately, Bonnie knows who he is because, you know, Anna had mentioned that a friend of hers from D.C. was supposed to have been seeing her before he went back to town. So now she knows why he didn't show up. So she lets her know that, you know, she's Anna's sister. And You know, so, and he's like wondering, you know, what's going on with her, and, you know, can you let her know that, could you actually call her and let her know that I'm here and everything, and, you know, Bonnie's like, yeah, I will. And then the next thing you know, Dr. Allen comes in like, JB, get your ass out there in them fields to help your brother. Like, don't you talk back to me. And then and then Bonnie's like, Dr. Allen, this is not JB. She's like, and then all of a sudden he's about to walk up. She's like, where are you going? She's like, I'm going to the bathroom. She's like, I can go with you. Like, I don't need you to go to the bathroom with me. I can go to the bathroom by myself. He's like, JB, get out of that bed. She's like, it's not JB. She's like, leave me alone, you old bitch. Dr. Allen is off the hook, man. I have to say, this episode was kind of dragging, but the thing that gave me life was Dr. Allen, because Dr. Allen is one of those characters that make the show, because he just goes in and out, and you don't know what he's going to get. And then, next thing you know, Victor starts laughing, and she's like, what the hell is so funny? She's like, look, obviously the doctor is not in right now, but sometimes life gets so bad that the only thing you have is humor. And I have to agree with that, you know. But he says, it just chuckles him like crazy, because he's like, wow. You know, he obviously not home, so he's the doctor. I know good and damn well he didn't operate on me, but he did. So they pretty much kind of chuckled at that. And next thing you know, he tells Bonnie that, look, when the doctor finally comes back, let him know that I need some painkillers because, you know, I'm really in pain right now. So she said, okay, and then she leaves off. And okay. Then, next thing you know, Brody comes in to check on him. He starts talking to Victor, and please tell me why this fool begins to flirt with Brody. Like, oh my God, I have died and gone to heaven. Are you Jesus? I'm like, Victor, you just got your ass beat, and you already still trying to pursue a straight man. And then he starts saying some shit like, well, you know, you are just one beautiful straight man. You'd be better off if you kind of let your labels go. And he's like, and Brody's like, what labels? And the thing is, Brody was real cool with it. You know, he wasn't acting like, you know, like JB. He was real chill. He wasn't taking offense to it. But you could tell Brody was kind of bothered. And he's like, well, you know those labels, you know, that, you know, man's supposed to be with girls and girls supposed to be with boys. Why don't you just relax your standards and just let yourself be free, you know? And then he asks, like, well, why did they beat you up? And he said, well, they beat me up because I'm bisexual. But for some people, I'm just straight up gay. I'm like, stop lying, bitch. You got beat up because your ass groped the dude on the dance floor, and then you started making an open play for the straight guys that was on the porch, and they whooped your ass. So I'm saying, but you brought it on yourself, but you made it seem as if, like, oh, they just beat me up because I'm bisexual. Yeah, bullshit. So then he starts saying that, you know, well, we actually got some painkillers down there, and, you know, I'm about to bring you some painkillers, but they're going to put you to sleep. He's like, oh, no, I don't want to go to sleep. I just want to look at you. You know, you're just a real sexy straight boy. And I'm like, you know what, Victor? Your ass hasn't learned a damn thing. You damn near got beat to the end of your fucking life. And you still trying to go after straight guys. And I'm like, and if Brody was another motherfucker, he probably would have killed Victor. But he's like, you know what, I'm going to get you these pain meds, and, you know, that's going to be the end of it. So Brody just ended up getting the hell up out of there. But then also while they were talking, he had mentioned, because he asked, do you know who did this to you? And he's like, well, there was some guy named Handel or Henry or something like that. And then the funny thing about it, there was another dude, I don't remember his name, but then there was this one guy, your father mentioned his name. His name was JB. He was another dude that was there who beat me up. So now they know that JB, you know, was one of the men who attacked him. He goes downstairs and talks to Bonnie. Bonnie overhears the conversation, so she knows that JB's involved, and she lets Brody know that me and JB are not together anymore. I'm over it, you know. And then they start having a conversation, because she's like, it's kind of funny that you were cool talking to him knowing that he's gay or whatever. And he's saying that, look, it's America. You know, there's different people all over this country. And she's like, well, yeah, but not up and happy. And they start having this conversation, but the next thing you know, Bonnie leans over and starts kissing Brody. Brody picks her up, and they are getting it on in the kitchen. They are turning up the heat. Shoot, they making their own damn stove. Finally, Anna, Dex, and Valerie arrive. Valerie knocks on the door, and she gets no answer. So she starts looking in the windows, and next thing you know, she looks through the window, and she sees Bonnie and Brody getting it on up in the kitchen. And I'm like, Anna, you can't be mad, bitch. Because at the end of the day, you left that man 3 years ago. You think he was going to be acne and sore nuts and was going to hold off and wait for your ass to come back? No, boo-boo. Because he was loving some Bonnie and Bonnie was loving some him, which is kind of like the undercoat of why she was asking Anna, does she still have feelings for Brody? Because she has feelings for Brody. And now she knows the truth that, yeah, Bonnie fucking Brody. What? So, that was the episode. Subscribe to my channel. Like this video. Leave comments. You know, I definitely want to hear you guys' feedback. And I think next week is going to be the season finale. So, hopefully, you know, we definitely get a lot more next week. But this week was pretty much more like a filler episode. But it was still, you know, it was still entertaining nonetheless. But, yeah, Dr. Allen gave me life. But, I'm about to sign off, guys. But thank you so much for your support. And I'll be back with you guys next week. So, take care.